It's Orson. Orson. Ugh.
Guests of the PM, the wife and two daughters of one Lance Donovan, the VP of Dynasty Global.
The online retailer?
Uh-huh. Donovan is back in London, working. He should receive the pictures as we speak.
Ah, blackmail.
Donovan's boss, Dynasty CEO Rupert Pierce, is a top Providence operative. But we can't get near him, so I decided to, well, do a bit of outsourcing. Oh, could you fix me a cup of tea?
Sure thing. You want sugar? Honey?
Honey.
No problema.
Mr. Donovan. Who I am is not important. You have seen the pictures, yes? Good. I will tell you exactly what to do. Do it swiftly and without question, and your wife and children go free, unharmed. Refuse or hesitate, and your family dies. Attempt to signal or warn anybody, and your family dies. Do we have terms? Not very convincing, Mr. Donovan. Take a deep breath and try again. Much better. Now, you will take the stairs up to the rooftop helipad where your boss, Rupert Pierce, is taking his morning jog. You will inform his guards that you are delivering an urgent message. You will approach Mr. Pierce, lure him close to the edge, and toss him off the building.
Hey, you want green tea or mango?
What do you think? You heard me, Mr. Donovan. The life of your boss for the life of your wife and daughters. Shouldn't be much of a choice, even for a workaholic. Do you understand me? Very good. Now, go. If I don't hear sirens from downtown London in 5 minutes, your family suffers the consequences. Best of luck, Mr. Donovan. We thank you for your sacrifice.
Is it done?
Good as.
And Mr. Donovan's wife and children?
The guys will let them go at the stroke of midnight, unless I say otherwise. Boss's orders. You know how to call it.
house about me.
When am I what?
You know what I mean. Welcome home, Alma. And guest. I'm staying here too, you know? Least you could do is teach it my name. Or maybe you don't expect to keep me around long enough to bother, is that it?
I didn't know it was that important to you, Orson. What can I say? My bad. I've been using the safe house for years.
Right, you and Sean. Bet the house knew his name.
Okay, I guess I could change it into... Welcome, Alma and Sean, too. How's that?
Funny.
Or maybe Second Sean. That has a nice ring to it, don't you think? Or Sean Light. You know what, I'll think of some more while I go and brush my teeth.
Fine. I'm gonna hit the shower.
You do that, Orson. I said, when are you shipping out again?
I'm supposed to rendezvous with the team in Riga, like 5 days from now. I've got no idea what the mission is or who my teammates are. Like, all this secrecy is starting to get on my nerves.
You know the boss, belt and suspenders kind of guy.
Well, I don't, and neither do you. That's kind of my point. Call me old-fashioned, but like I say, I like to know who I'm risking my life for.
You know why? The rest are details.
It's easy for you to say. At least you're in the loop.
I take orders just like you. In fact, the boss deliberately keeps me out of the loop. I don't even know who the other cells are. Compartmentalization is key.
Yeah, I guess. That's Sean.
Dad has been silent about the incident, but CEO Robert Knox is expected to make a statement early next week.
There.
Teen fans are barely out of their mourning period. And this just in. In downtown London, a man has allegedly plummeted to his death from the headquarters of Dynasty Global, the world's largest internet retailer. While the identity is unconfirmed, several eyewitness tweets claim that the deceased is none other than Rupert Pierce, Dynasty's founder and CEO. We will keep you updated as this story develops. I am Pam Kingsley, GNN News.
Well, that's that. Smoke on the balcony?
Yeah, sure. How about a scotch?
No, I just brushed my teeth.
Oh, well, suit yourself. I'm having one before bed then. Good for the blood flow.
There's a place underground.
That reminds me, I need you to do something for me.
Okay. What's the gig?
It's a cakewalk, really. I just need you and the boys to pick up a shipment in Brussels 3 days from now. A truckload of cutting-edge Kronstadt Industries military hardware. Drones and shit. You'll get a kick out of it, I promise.
Well, shit, the Knoxes really are defecting. High-level Providence stooges like them, that's a real feather in your cap. So why aren't you the one doing the honors?
See, there's just a teensy possibility that it could be a trap. And if it is, well, I'm too important to risk.
Wow.
Don't start.
No, I get it. Everyone's expendable, but some are more expendable than others. Is that it?
I wouldn't put it on a t-shirt, but, well, yeah. In a nutshell.
Fine, I'll do it. I know you can hold your own and all that, but I want you to be safe, Alma. I mean, I'd hate it if... Jeez, it's chilly out here.
Hey, any sign of Max?
No, man. But one of the lads found a bunch of dead sheep down the road. Max.
Nightcap? cap? Hell yeah.
Oh well, as long as he's happy.
Night, Alma. If you need your grass, the bag's in the medical cabinet.
No need. I'm dog tired. The second I close my eyes, I'll be dead to the world. Night, second Sean.
Shut up.
Talk it down. Well done, 47. Now get off the property.